QuadJacks.com. Welcome back. My old pal, Tony Dunst.
What's going on, Marco? I'm very good.
It seems like I've been interviewing you all my life.
I think your entire poker life, I've generally been amicable to giving interviews.
I think, actually, you were one of my very first interviews. This
really?
In 2010, when you won the beer pong.
Ah, yeah, yeah. That would have been a different kind of interview.
What's that?
That would have been a different kind of interview.
Yeah. A little bit different than the one that we're doing now. First of all, congratulations on the premiere of the movie.
Thank you.
Bet Race Full last night. I wasn't able to make it.
Okay.
But I heard it was a great success. People loved it.
I liked it. I hadn't seen it yet, and I was happy with how it turned out.
You haven't
out.
Seen it yet until...
No.
Oh, you haven't?
No, okay. I told Ryan initially, I was like, I want to sweat it all the way to the end with you and kind of see the cut that everyone else gets to see their
right.
first time.
And you were pleased.
I was, yes.
Tell us a little bit about this movie and your role in it.
Sure. So it really follows the storylines of three protagonists. Myself, Danielle Anderson, who's a mother from Minnesota who supported her family through her winnings in online poker prior to Black Friday. And then Martin Bradstreet, who was a really successful high-stakes player and a sort of very articulate strategist, thinker of poker and a musician. And a lot of the story is kind of the ups and downs for Danielle and I, while Martin remains fairly consistent, and he's a little more removed from it up in Canada. So the plot of the movie follows our own storylines, while also filling in the details on online poker's history, general poker's history, showing a lot of clips from the old shows or the old World Series and WPTs, and kind of tying it all together so someone outside of poker can understand what our history over the last 10 years in this business has been.
Right. And what has that history been like, would you say?
Tumultuous. They obviously start off when
you definitely
Chris
look
Money
awful,
Mayweather.
Tony. You definitely look
Thank
battered.
You. Thank
like
you.
Like this industry has just ravaged you.
Ravaged me with age. They start off in like the just pre-Moneymaker era, and then they kind of go over Moneymaker and what effect that had on the game. And then they sort of cut between Danielle and Martin and I talking about our beginnings in poker and how we got into it. And then they start doing, you know, like UIGEA, the golden years, the big competition between PokerStars and Full Tilt to acquire the U.S. market, Black Friday, and how each company reacted after Black Friday. So, you know, I think that's... And then at the end, of course, I don't want to spoil anything, but I think everyone knows, you know, poker becoming legalized in Nevada, in New Jersey, and very likely across the United States in a state-by-state manner in the coming years.
Spoiler alert, by
Spoiler
the way.
Alert.
Now, I saw you tweet something the other day, something like the big plight of the World Series of Poker is eye contact or something like that.
In the hallways, yeah.
I'm thankful for how much you've given me.
Right, right.
I
more so mean that in the sense of, like, so the World Series is like coming back to high school every single day for like 6 weeks, and you see the same people you've seen here over the years, and you see the same people day after day, and it's like if you walk around the hallways making eye contact with everyone, you have to stop and have like 12 different conversations just to kind of like get through the hallway, whereas half the time you're like booking it to a tournament, or you really got to use the bathroom, or you want to get outside and have a smoke, or just whatever it is, and you just got to like head down, facing your phone, book it through, and then like sometimes, especially like late at night when it's a little more chill in here and not the sort of 2 p.m. craziness, you know, you want to wander around with a beer, bump into your friends, hang, chill, chat out, when you don't have anywhere to be. I kind of like doing that with the World Series, but when I'm here to play tournaments and I'm here to work, like, it's kind of a different vibe than here to socialize, and I'm happy to say hi to people and what's up during the break, but I'm not in a, like, super chatty, gregarious mood when I'm trying to concentrate on poker.
So, if ever Tony Dunst seems a little standoffish in the hallway,
I'm just at work.
Not intentional.
Yeah, exactly.
You're just focused. You're in the
yep,
zone.
Yeah, I'm in the zone.
Good luck, sir.
Thanks, man.
Tony Dunst, Bet Race Full, the movie.
The movie.
Or is there a book, too? Or
I'm writing a book, but it's not going to be about, it's not Bet Race Full or anything like that.
Quick blurb about the book. Come on.
It's called, right now, How To's You'll Never Use, and it's kind of, instead of talking about really the like history of online poker, it just kind of examines the lifestyle that the guys growing up as adolescents or young males were allowed during that period, but it's really not very poker heavy. It's kind of about all the other things in life that poker allowed me and my friends to do away from the game, and then the narrative is driven forward by the history of poker and my experiences in it. But you know, it's not the kind of thing where you're reading a bunch of hand histories. There's no strategy. It's not even...
Oh, damn, I was looking forward to that book by you, Tony Dunst.
Sorry, man.
Okay. Maybe the next one.
Okay.
All right, you gotta get back.
I gotta go.
Good luck, sir.
See you later.
You're the man. Tony Dunst.
Those are mine.
No. But if you want to avoid eye contact more easily.
I know, right?